I believe this is video 7. I'm trying to make sure that when I speak that my pronunciation comes out clearly. I sometimes bite my tongue at night and I kind of feel like I'm developing some sort of a side lisp, or at least it sounds like it when I listen to my voice on video. So, The Great Gatsby. I hope people realize I'm not just reading out loud. I'm doing literary analysis of the novel and also giving grammar tips and providing insight from the perspective of a literature teacher. I have been a teacher for 33 years, and that's what qualifies me to do this. I have a bachelor's, a master's, a postgrad, and I'm more than qualified to do this. I don't think teachers get the respect that they deserve. Oftentimes we are treated like we're not worthy, but there's still a huge place in this world for educators, and I believe in education as a form of freedom. And I don't mean just education as in getting a degree from a university, but also learning on your own, reading, learning from people who know more than you. Whenever I talk to someone who has a doctorate, who has more experience and more knowledge than me, I listen and I want to learn. Page 22, if this is the edition that you're looking at. I'll show you how I've gotten to feel about things. Well, she was less than an hour old, and Tom was God knows where. I woke up out of the ether with an utterly abandoned feeling and asked the nurse right away if it was a boy or a girl. She told me it was a girl, and so I turned my head away and wept. All right, I said, I'm glad it's a girl, and I hope she will be a fool. That's the best thing a girl can be in the world, in this world. A beautiful little fool. You see, I think everything's terrible anyhow, she went on in a convinced way. Everybody thinks so, the most advanced people. And I know, I've been everywhere and seen everything and done everything. Her eyes flashed around in a default way, rather like Tums, and she laughed. With thrilling scorn. Sophisticated. God, I'm sophisticated. The instant her voice broke off, ceasing to compel my attention, my belief, I felt the basic insincerity of what she had said. It made me uneasy, as though the whole evening had been a trick of some sort to exact a contributory emotion from me. I waited for sure enough in a moment. She looked at me with an absolute smirk on her lovely face, as if she had asserted her membership in a rather distinguished secret society to which she and Tom belonged. Inside, the crimson room bloomed with light. Tom and Miss, not Mrs. What's the difference between Miss, Mrs. and Ms? I ask my students this question, but not a lot of people know. So, Miss, M-I-S-S. If a woman is single, you'll call her by Miss and her last name. My daughter, Skylar. Her name is Skylar Nielsen. She's not married, she's single. So, she's Miss Nielsen. I am married, have have been for 26 years, with the ups and downs that come with any relationship. But I digress. So I am Mrs. Nilsson. M-R-S. Mrs. Now let us just say that I don't want people to know that I don't think it's any of their business whether I'm married or not. Then I'd be Ms. Nilsson. M-S dot Ms. It's very, how do I put it? I think it's a very feminist thing to do. Ms. Because it's nobody's business if I'm married or not. So Miss Baker, because she wasn't married at the time. Miss, M-I-S-S. Inside a crimson room bloomed with light, Tom and Miss Baker sat at either end of the long couch, and she read aloud to him from the Saturday Evening Post. The words, murmurs, and uninflected, running together in a soothing tune. The lamplight bright on his boots and dull on the autumn leaf yellow of her hair glinted along the paper as she turned a page with a flutter of slender muscles in her arms. I'm not wearing glasses right now, and I'm having difficulty reading some of the words. When we came in, she held us silent for a moment with a lifted hand. To be continued, she said, tossing the magazine on the table. In our very next issue. Her body asserted itself with a restless movement of her knee, and she stood up. 10 o'clock, she remarked, apparently finding the time on the ceiling. Time for this good girl to go to bed. Jordan's going to play in a tournament tomorrow, explained Daisy. Over as Westchester. Oh, you're Jordan Baker? I knew now why her face was familiar. Its pleasing, contemptuous expression had looked out at me from many rotogravure. That is quite the word. R-O-T-O-G-R-A-V-U-R-E. Quite the word of the sporting life at Asheville and Hot Springs and Palm Beach. I had heard some story of her too. A critical, unpleasant story. But what it was, I had forgotten long ago. Good night, she said softly. Wake me at 8, won't you? If you'll get up. I will. Good night, Mr. Carraway. See you anon. Of course you will, confirmed Daisy. In fact, I think I'll arrange a marriage. Come over often, Nick. And I'll sort of, fling you together, you know, lock you up accidentally in linen closets and push you. I say linen, she says linen, in linen closets and push you out to sea in a boat and all that sort of thing. Good night, called Miss Baker from the stairs. I haven't heard a word. She's a nice girl, said Tom after a moment. They oughtn't let her run around the country this way. Who oughtn't to? Inquired Daisy coldly. Her family. Her family is one aunt about a thousand years old. Besides, Nick's going to look after her, aren't you? Aren't you, Nick? She's going to spend lots of weekends out here this summer. I think the home influence will be good for her. Will be very good for her. Daisy and Tom looked at each other for a moment in silence. Is she from New York? I asked quickly. From Louisville. Our white girlhood was passed together there. Our beautiful white Did you give Nick a little heart-to-heart talk on the veranda? Demanded Tom suddenly. I wanted to read a little bit more and do more explanations and talk about feminism and talk about the way women were when this book was written, or at least in the time that it portrays. There's portrayed in the book and the movie as well. There is a passage where Daisy talks about her little girl being a fool and talking about how women were in this world for marriage and to serve man, basically. Makes you think about the role of women at the time, but we'll get back to that.